हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच क्लास सेवेंथ। द सब्जेक्ट इज इंग्लिश। द सब सब्जेक्ट इज हनीकॉम एंड द टॉपिक इज फायर, फ्रेंड एंड फो। दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 8। दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 8 इन योर बुक। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच क्लास 7। द सब्जेक्ट इज इंग्लिश। द सब सब्जेक्ट इज हनीकॉम। टॉपिक इज फायर, फ्रेंड एंड फो। And this is chapter number 8 in your book. Today we will do the exercise of this chapter. So let's start. Open page number 118. Mark the first question is mark the correct answer in each of the following. The first question, in first question there are two multiple choice questions. We have to choose the correct answer. The first one is first question. The first one is early man was frightened of, early man was frightened of a lightning and volcanoes, lightning and volcanoes, b the damage caused by them and c fire. So the answer of this question will be, the correct answer is fire. The early man was frightened of fire. Now let us see the second one. In the second one, here are only option and there is only one correct option. We have to choose that correct option. A is fire is energy. Fire is energy. B, fire is heat and light. Fire is heat and light. C, fire is the result of chemical reaction. Fire is the result of chemical reaction. In this chapter we have read that fire is the result of chemical reaction. So the C one is correct. In second one, the C one is correct. Fire is the result of chemical reaction. The second question is, from the boxes given below, choose the one with the correct order of the following sentences. Here are four sentences and we have to write those sentences into correct order. Here are given four option and in those four option, one option is correct, but I will write only the correct option. So first of all, let us see how can we arrange the sentences. The first one is, the first in question, the first one is, that is fire. That is fire. The second is, a chemical reaction takes place. A chemical reaction takes place. Third is energy in the form of heat and light, energy in the form of heat and light, heat and light is released, is released. And the fourth one is oxygen combines with carbon and hydrogen, oxygen combines with carbon and hydrogen. So we have to arrange these sentences into correct order. So the first sentence will be oxygen combines with carbon and hydrogen, fourth. Then a chemical reaction takes place because of this combination, a chemical reaction takes place, second one. And then energy in the form of heat and light is released because of chemical reaction, energy in the form of heat and light is released, third. And then that is fire, that is called the fire. So the option with four, second, then third one is the correct option. You have three more options, but the correct one is this option. So you see which is this option, and this option will be the correct one. Now see page number 119. Here are questions. If there are questions and I have to write the answers, then I will only tell you the questions and answers. And you can see the written form, type form of questions and answers at my left hand side. So the first question is, what do you understand by the flash point of a fuel? The first question is, what do you understand by the flash point of a fuel? So the answer of this question will be the particular temperature at which a fuel begins to burn, the particular temperature at which a fuel begins to burn is called the flash point of a fuel. Now see the second one. The second question is divided into two parts. The second 2.1 is, what are some common uses of fire? So you can see the answer of this question at page number 115. It is given, we use it to cook our food, warm our homes in winter, and to generate electricity. So this is the common use of fire. And the second one, 2.2, is in what sense it is a bad master? In what sense it is it a bad master? The answer of this question will be, it is also given on page number 115. If fire gets out of control, it can be very dangerous. If fire get out of control, it can be very dangerous, and also it causes the destruction of life and, here we can say, property, life and property. So it causes the destruction of life and property. Now see the third one. The third question is, match items in column A with those in column B. So here are two columns, column A and column B, and we have to match the items from column A to column B. In column A, the first one is fuel, the second one is oxygen, and the third is heat. And in column B, here are many options. A, lighted matchstick स्टिक, बी एयर, सी कोल, डी बर्निंग कोल। ई वुड, एफ स्मोल्डरिंग पेपर, एंड जी इज कुकिंग गैस, कुकिंग गैस। सो वी हैव टू मैच दीज कॉलम ए विथ कॉलम बी। सो वी नो दैट फ्यूल, एयर, कोल, कोल इज यूज्ड एज फ्यूल, वुड, वुड इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड एज फ्यूल, एंड कुकिंग गैस, कुकिंग गैस इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड एज फ्यूल। एंड नाउ सी ऑक्सीजन, एयर इज द ऑक्सीजन, एयर कंटेन्स द ऑक्सीजन, हीट, लाइटेड मैच स्टिक प्रोड्यूस द हीट, एंड बर्निंग कोल, बर्निंग कोल ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस द हीट, दिस स्मोल्डरिंग पेपर, स्मोल्डरिंग पेपर ऑल्सो प्रोड्यूस द हीट। सो यू कैन मैच दीज वर्ड्स इन दिस वे। नाउ सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज What are the three main ways in which a fire can be controlled or put out? What are the three main ways in which a fire can be controlled or put out? The answer of this question will be, the first one, 3 points is asked. So the first one, take away the fuel. You take away the fuel. If the fire has no fuel to feed on, no burning can take place. The second option will be prevent oxygen from reaching it. Prevent oxygen from reaching the fire. No supply of oxygen means no fire. If there is not any supply of oxygen, there will not be any fire. And the third one, remove the heat. If there is heat, you try to remove that heat. If the temperature can be brought down below the flash point, the fuel stops burning. So this is the answer of question number 4. Now see the question number 5. Question number 5 is match the items in box A with those in box B. We have to match the items here too. We will make it in columns. It is given box, but we will write it in columns. So the first one is to burn paper or a piece of wood. To burn paper or a piece of wood. Second is small fires can be put out. Small fires can be put out. Third is when water is spread on fire. And fourth is a carbon dioxide extinguisher, carbon dioxide extinguisher is the best thing. And the fifth one is space left between buildings space left between buildings. And here A is, it absorbs heat from the burning material. It absorbs heat from the burning from the burning material and lowers the temperature B is reduces the risk of fire and C is with a damp blanket and E is we heat it before it catches fire. We heat it before it catches fire. And F and last one is to put out an electrical fire. To put out an electrical fire. Electrical fire. And we have to match these words column A with column B. In column A, to burn paper or piece of wood. For burning, we heat it before it catches fire. So first one will be matched with E. The second one is small fires can be put out with a damp blanket. If there is a damp blanket, small fire can be put out. C. Second one will be matched with C. And the third one, when water is spread on fire, it absorbs heat from the burning material and lowers the temperature. So third one will be matched with A. And the fourth one is a carbon dioxide extinguisher is the best thing to put out an electric fire. To put out an electric fire. The fourth one will be matched with the F. And space left between buildings reduces the risk of fire. So fifth one will be matched with B. So you can match these words column A with column B in this way. Now see the next page, page number 120, and it is question number 6. Question number 6 is, I will tell you the questions and the answers, and you can see typed form of questions and answers at my left side. So the question number 6 is, why does a burning candle go out when you blow on it? The question is, why does a burning candle go out when you blow on it? The answer of this question will be, when we blow on a burning candle, the hot air around the candle is replaced by cold air, and it brings down the temperature of the candle below the flash point. The next question is, spraying water is not a good way of putting out an oil fire or an electricity fire. Why not? The question is, spraying water is not a good way of putting out an oil fire or an electrical fire. Why not? The answer of this question will be, if water is spread onto an oil fire, the oil will float on the water and will continue to burn if we spread the water on the oil fire. It will float, the oil will float on the water and it will continue to burn. And this will be the same with electricity fire. Electricity is also a good conductor of water is a good conductor of electricity, and with the help of water the electricity can spread all over. That is the reason that we should not use water in oil fire and electricity fire. Now see the eighth question, number 8. It is, what are some of the things you should do to prevent a fire at home and in the school? We should try to keep away the things that can that can take the fires. We should use the utensils, we should use the things that are most important to prevent the fire. So there may be many things that we can use to prevent the fire from our houses and school. Now see the next one, working with language. It is given, read the following sentences. Here is a paragraph. The paragraph is, to burn paper or a piece of wood, we heat it before it catches fire. We generally do it with a lighted match. Every fuel has a particular temperature at which it burns. This is the paragraph. And now it is given. The verbs in italics in the paragraph are in the simple present tense. When we use it, we are not thinking only about the present. We use it to say that something happens all the time or repeatedly, or that something is true in general. Find 10 examples of verbs in the simple present tense in the text fire, friend and foe, and write them down here. Do not include any passive verbs. We have to write the verbs in here, can say we have to write the verbs in simple present tense. So we have to write the verbs that are used in the chapter, in this chapter. So number 1, no. Number 2, combines. Number 3, burst. Number 4, comes. Number 5, catches. Number 6, blow. Number 7, observes. Number 8, means. Number 9, allow. And number 10, helps, or any other verb that are used in the book. Now see the second one. The second one is, fill in the blanks in the sentences below with words from the box. You may use a word more than once. We can use the word more than once. Here are given 4 words: carbon, cause, fire, smoother. We can use these words more than once, but we have to fill the blanks only with these 4 words. The first one is, Gandhiji's life was devoted to the cause. We will fill here cause. Cause of justice and fair play. The second one is, have you insured your house against? We will use here fire, against fire. The third one is, diamond is nothing but we will fill here carbon in its pure form. Number 4 is, if you put too much coal on the fire at once, you will, here we will fill with smoother, you will smoother it. Number 5 is, smoking is said to be the main, here we will use cause, main cause of heart disease. Number 6 is, when asked by an ambitious writer whether he should put some, here we will fill with fire, into his stories, Somerset Maugham murmured, no, the other way round. Number 7 is, she is a, here we will fill carbon, she is a carbon copy of her mother. And number 8 is, it is often difficult to smoother, we will fill here smoother. It is often difficult to smoother a yarn when you listen to a long speech on the value of time. Now see question number 3 on page number 121. Question number 3 is, one word is italicized in each sentence. Find its opposite in the box and fill in the blanks. They are given five sentences. In those five sentences, one word is italicized and the opposite of that word is given here, and we have to choose the correct opposite word to fill those sentences. Number one is spending, second shut, third destroy, fourth subtract, fifth increase. The first sentence is, you are required to keep all the doors open. Open is italicized. We have to find out the opposite of open, not shut. Shut is the opposite of open. In the second, people said, here is the dialogue of people. He said, what mark did I get in yesterday's maths test? Then the teacher replied, you got what you get when you add 5 and 5 and add. Add is italicized, the opposite of add is given here, subtract, and subtract 10 from the total. Now, the third one is, run 4 kilometers a day to preserve your health. Preserve is italicized, we have to find the opposite of preserve. Your health, run a lot more to destroy. The opposite of preserve here given, destroy it. And the fourth one is, if a doctor advises a lean and lanky patient to reduce, reduce is italicized. We have to find the opposite of reduce. Patient to reduce his weight further, be sure he is doing it to increase. Increase here is given, increase. The opposite of reduce is given, increase his income. The fifth and last one is, the world is too much with us, late and soon, getting. Getting is italicized, getting and spending. Spending is the opposite of getting. Getting and spending will lay waste our powers. So these are the questions. Now see the next one. The next question is, use the words given in the box to fill in the blanks in sentences below. Here also four words, we can say use one word more than once. First word is across, second along, third past, fourth through. Here fill in the blanks, and we have to use only these four words to fill the blanks. The first sentence is, the cat chased the mouse. Here we will fill with across the lawn. Second one, we were not allowed to cross the frontier, so we drew. Here we will fill with along. Drew along it as far as we could and came back happy. Now see the next page number 122. The third one is, the horse went. Here we will fill with past, the winning post, and had to be stopped with difficulty. The fourth sentence is, it is not difficult to see through. Here we will fill with through. See through your plan, anyone can see your motive. Now see the fifth and last one, go. We will fill with along. Go along the yellow line, then turn left, you will reach the post office in 5 minutes. So we will fill these sentences with these words. So now the exercise is completed. Exercise of this chapter is completed. So my class is over for today. My class is over. Thank you. Have a nice day.